السلام عليكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله ربه بالهدى ودين الحق رحمة للعالمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمي وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد عباد الله أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله العظيم تعالى وطاعته واتباع أمره واجتناب نهيه كما قال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما جعلنا جميعا منهم يا رب العالمين أما بعد respected brothers and honored sisters in Islam We humans have our own nature and instinct of keep wishing, dreaming, and planning to grow and to have more. Sometimes those students have, maybe their wish is just to graduate, or maybe to get A, maybe to get the wish of someone to get to find a job, maybe to be promoted in that job, maybe to live in certain house, to drive certain car, to have certain income, maybe to get married, maybe to have children, maybe to have more children. So there is no human, rich or poor, young or old, he or she, but he or she have their own wishes. And these wishes vary from one person to another person. I have a relative, subhanAllah, and he has PhD. His wife has PhD. Both of them teach in a university. They have a stable income, mashallah. They are doing good. They are good at practicing. They have good families. We got married almost the same time, but they do not have children. They went from doctor to doctor, exam to exam, try. SubhanAllah, they could not. I'm sure their number one wish in this life just to have a child. And that similar cases are so many. And they are willing to pay all the money they have just for sake of having a child. Someone else who has 6, 7, 8, sometimes 9 or 10, mashallah, children, I'm sure he or she, the parents, their wish list is little different. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and our families. Allahumma ameen. So the fact here that we have different wish lists. And I want to bring your attention, brothers and sisters, to something. During this pandemic, as an imam, I visit patients in the hospitals more than one time. And you see some patients on the ventilators, those who have the COVID and cannot breathe by themselves, say they put them in the machine to breathe. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, the number and the one and the only wish he or she have is just to be able to breathe normally. Somebody who's paralyzed on the wheelchair, their wish will be just to be able to walk normally. What I want to say, brothers and sisters, look at us, mashallah. Breathe. We are breathing normally. What we take for granted, because we already have it, others, this is the only wish they have day or night. Not only those on the machine who cannot breathe, this is the only wish for him or her, or for their family members and their beloved one, who are willing to pay everything to spend day and night next to the bed just for have this beloved one to breathe normally. SubhanAllah. These treasures, we already have them. We are breathing normally. We are working normally. Look, we came, we parked our car, we took the stairs, we came and we are sitting, we are standing, we are making ruku' and sujood. Say alhamdulillah. So this really turned us to a fact that we humans tend to focus on what we do not have, and to forget and to take for granted the things that we already have. I will tell you about myself. I'm an immigrant. I came from the Middle East 27 years ago. When I came, the first few years, my wish was just to have my document. I cannot be this work permit year to year. I wish I have a green card. I wish they process that. Then I wish I have my citizenship, so I have peace of mind. I can go out and without really a denial of re-entry. Then, subhanAllah, when you get that, when I got that, did I stop? No, we do not stop, brothers and sisters. Those who parents, their wish is, I just find something to own instead of keep wasting this money for rent and any apartment. When I get the apartment, am I gonna stop? Will not stop. You know, I wish the kids grow up. I wish I can move to a house. When I move to a house, am I gonna stop? I will not stop. I wish I moved to a larger house, house in this zip code, house with these features, furniture, car. Those who do not have job, I wish I can have any job. When I get a job, I wish I have better job. When I get a better job, I wish I can be promoted. I'm targeting high. Nothing wrong with that, brothers and sisters. This is our nature. In Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari and Sahih al-Imam Muslim, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and listen to this hadith. لو كان لابن آدم واديان من ذهب لابتغى إليهما ثالثا ولا يملأ فم بن آدم إلا التراب. And considering the different narrations of this hadith in al-Bukhari and Muslim and other resources, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying this, had the son of Adam has a filling of a valley of gold or money. You know, imagine a valley full of gold and money for one person. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he or she will be seeking a second one. Will not stop. Can you imagine you have a valley or a house full of gold and money? You will spend your life and cannot even spend these monies. Look at those who have millions, not millions, billions. Did they stop working? Did they stop the plan day and night, thinking, calculating? Did their greed stop? No. I need more. I need more. You know, in the pandemic, I was reading about this Amazon guy that one night. Next day he woke up, his wealth increased $14 billion. Did he stop? No, he did not stop. And so the Prophet ﷺ said, even if the son of Adam has two loads of valleys, God will seek a third one. Nothing will stop the human except death. So Muslims or non-Muslims, rich or poor, young or old, whatever ethnicity or color or background or circumstances or degree or liver or intellectuality, we seek more. Now, to be in the safe side, since this is our nature, two things. And you'll be okay to target as high as you wish. You'll not regret. Number one, be sure it is halal way coming in, it is halal way going out. Number two, do not forget to say alhamdulillah, ashukrulillah. You pay the due, the zakat, the sadaqah Allah commanded to be in the safe side. So when we focus on what we do not have and forget what we have, how not to lack the balance, how not to be ungrateful to Allah, Rasulullah ﷺ gave us an advice. So you not forget to say Alhamdulillah. Rasulullah ﷺ said, and this hadith in al-Bukhari and Muslim as well, انظروا إلى من هو أسفل منكم ولا تنظروا إلى من هو فوقكم ذلك أدنى ألا تزدروا نعمة ربكم عليكم فهو أجدر أَلَّا تَزْدَرُوا نِعْمَةَ رَبِّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ. The Prophet ﷺ said, what means, while you are accelerating and seeking more, do not forget to look at those who have less than you. Do not always focus on those who have more than you. If you have that courtesy, if you remember to check on those who have less than you, that will make you closer not to ignore Allah's blessings, not to underestimate, not to undermine Allah's blessings and graces upon you. You know, I will tell you a story, brothers and sisters, because as we grow in the life, even our priorities will shift. I remember when we were young, maybe the hairstyle, what people think of me, compare myself with others. As we grow in the life and getting more mature, have more experience, these priorities will shift, and Al-Qur'an al-Kareem and the hadith of Rasulullah ﷺ are not silent about that regret, brothers and sisters. Sometimes things we focus a lot, we compete a lot, we compare a lot, we consider them top priorities. The moment we reach our deathbed, end of our life, and the life after, wallahi, this priority list, this wish list will shift into something different. I will tell you a story from non-Muslims. Australian nurse was working in the hospice. Like, this is end-of-life patients who have hospital, cannot do anything. They move them to a place called hospice. This nurse worked for 8 years there. And she had the courtesy, always the curiosity, to ask this dying patient, is there anything you regret in your life? Look at the question. And she was taking notes. After 8 years of working in the hospice, listen carefully. She published an article that the title of this article, you, by the way, you can Google it, you can read it. The top five regrets of dying people. And she listed those who were to focus a lot on work day and night. We regret that. They used to ignore their family and the relationship and the social, we regret that, and so on. So these are non-Muslims listing what I'm telling you. Al-Quran al-Kareem confirms that. The Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ confirms that, that we, even the believers, when we come at the end of our life, we will be regretting things. And we might be losing because of too much focus on things and ignoring other things. Where is that in the Quran? Many ayat. Listen to this ayah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. You and me. Inshallah. La tulhikum amwalukum wala awladukum an dhikrillah. Do not let your children, your wealth take away from the remembrance of Allah. Our children. I have 6 children. We are thinking of their prosperity and success and empowering them day and night. This is number one focus. We are willing to sacrifice everything for our children. Wa amwalukum, and our wealth. This is the most beloved thing we have. Okay, we check our accounts. We are happy, rejoice when we make money and more money and save money and buy something with money. All of us, including myself. Allah said, okay, with that, do not let this take you away from the remembrance of Allah. If that happens, you are losers. وَأَنْفِقُوا the second ayah. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِي أَحْدَكُمُ الْمَوْتُ فَيَقُولُ. And spend of what we granted you, Allah says, before the death approaches one of you, upon that, in the end of my life, in the end of your life, one will say, فَيَقُولُ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. I will say, my Lord, could you just give me a break? Delay me for a while. Why? Because I need to do something I put in the bottom of my list. I ignore. فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. I need to make sadaqah. I need to make righteous good deeds. I need to do more righteousness. Subhanallah al-Azim. The answer from Allah, وَلَا يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah will never delay a soul which destiny has come. And Allah is fully aware, acquainted of what you do. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us from the Quran al-Azim. أقول قبل هذا وأستغفر الله لكم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا. Brothers and sisters, it is everywhere in the Quran, many ayat. قالوا ربنا أبصرنا وسمعنا فرجعنا نعمل صالحا إنا موقنون. فيقول رب ارجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها. آيات, all of them tell us at the moment of death and the life after, one regret for everyone, that is the righteous good deeds, in particular the sadaqah that I wish I did more. Now brothers and sisters, in the last 2 minutes of my khutbah, my name is Ahmed Shqirat. I'm here today representing an 100% Islamic, 100% legal relief organization called UHR, UnitedHandRelief.org. You can check their website. They are working in 14 different countries, including Gaza. And I say Gaza because getting a license to work in Gaza is not an easy. Only very few Muslim American organizations have access to send food. So the envelope here, we have 2 envelopes. One marked Gaza, and you will see the program there. Water tank, filling the water with water, medical aid, food basket, $100 a month for the whole family, and the Qurbani. And you will see this envelope here, the Qurbani, which is the Udhiya, in 14 different countries. Please, when we talk about our Muslims, we are talking about tens of millions of refugees and orphans. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, I have high cholesterol myself. Wallahi, and mainly you need to reduce eating red meat as one of the medical advices and other things. But these brothers and sisters, they do not have access to even clean food and clean water. When I talk about Gaza in particular, look, brothers and sisters, all of them are our brothers and sisters everywhere. There is no difference. Feel free to choose from the envelope where we are, what you like. But I'm focusing on Gaza in particular because I'm talking about 2 million Muslims under sanction from the sea, from the air, from the land for how many years so far? Like 90% of their water is contaminated, not clean for the drinking. 20% of the sewage is running on the street, no service. They do not have their employment, unemployment rate, if you think it's high, 7%, it's 48% and more. Families with children cannot feed, do not have enough medical aid, do not have those who have kidney failure, do not have even the machines. So very, very, very restricted area. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy on them and give them victory. And we know the news, we know what they are facing. This is, I am focusing here. But if you like to name your udhiyah or your food basket in any other country, feel free. But if you do not name it, it will go automatically, as this is the focus of my campaign today to Gaza. Before stepping down, I want to tell you a story. And I will tell you even the names. I was in Albuquerque Islamic Center. Entered the masjid to do a khutbah 3 weeks ago for Gaza. And subhanAllah, a medical doctor, neurologist. He said, Imam, salam alaikum, my name is Khadr, Dr. Khadr. He said, I am a medical doctor, neurologist in the hospital, and I have a patient who has a spine injury, paralyzed. And this person running behind in the medical bills and in the utility and very poor. But 3 days ago, he came to me and he said, Dr. Khadr, I know you are a Muslim. I want this $100 to go to my brothers and sisters in Gaza. And the doctor took the $100 and gave it to me, wallahi, before I walked to the minbar. So I asked him, is he from Palestine? He said, no. Is he from the Middle East? No. Is he a Muslim, this patient? He said, no, wallahi, he's a Polish. He's from Poland. He said, he read in the news, the war against this regime, against this is Gaza Strip, and he said, I want to support my brothers and sisters in Gaza. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, look, this is non-Muslim person, not maybe never even been in that region, and he feels with his brothers and sisters in Gaza. So please consider this an opportunity will make us regret less upon in our death and in the life after. Consider this an opportunity for you and for me to do righteous good deeds. Food basket for the whole family, for the whole month, $100. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, we go to the restaurant, we have small banquet, we spend more than $100. Tell me yes or no. So let us, inshallah, have food basket, have, there is a program called Remodeling Houses Demolished by the Israeli strikes. If you want to participate, please do. At least have your qurbani. In Gaza, $295, by the way. There is no sheep or goat. It's only cow, share of cow. Maybe Allah bless you. I know it's not a must in udhiyah, but maybe Allah bless you to sponsor the whole cow. Maybe another, maybe kafara, maybe aqiqa, maybe on behalf of your parents, on behalf of what? Let's do one step and make dua. Oh Allah, make it recovery for them, make it recovery for me. Make it a blessing for them, make it a blessing for me. And wallahi, brothers and sisters, whatever we advance, we'll not regret. I'm telling you about the righteous early Muslims, when they used to see the needy, they will welcome the needy, and they ask their best customer who will take their means for the day of judgment. This is an opportunity. Look at it, you deposit your account with Allah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. Make it sincerely for the sake of Allah with a humility and make dua. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الحاضرين والغائبين الأحياء والميتين. يا ربنا ألف بين قلوبنا وحد صفوفنا لم شملنا اجمع كلمتنا بارك أخوتنا وفق قادتنا لما تحب وترضى يا رب العالمين. من أراد بالإسلام وأهله وبلاده ومقدساته خيرا اللهم خذ بيده إلى كل خير. من أراد بالإسلام وأهله وبلاده ومقدساته شرا فاكفنا اللهم شره يا رب العالمين. عباد الله اذكروه الله يذكركم اشكروه على نعمه يزدكم أقم الصلاة. رحم الله امرأة السلام نفسه. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين. ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
Allahu Akbar. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Respected brother, assalamu alaikum. Could you give me, inshallah, only 2 minutes of your time? I will not increase. As I mentioned, inshallah, you can choose any country of your choice, but my focus is on Gaza. And I need those who are willing to combine their udhiyah with food basket, with water tank, whatever, can have a few of us. By the way, the brothers downstairs, we have also the donation box and the envelopes, and in your way outside, we have the table. And if you like to use your credit card on the spot, take your receipt, we have the credit card machine, inshallah. You can write check to the organization, you can pay cash, whatever. Whatever you pledge, you can make it one payment, you can make it 5 payments, 10 payments, if it's not for the udhiyah. So can I have a few of us who are willing, inshallah, to say $2,500 from my zakah, that will be, inshallah, for to support this campaign for Gaza or any other country of your choice. Can have the first one to say $2,500. Could be one payment, could be 5 payments, could be credit card, could whatever. We have the machine if you like, inshallah. Do we have one person here to say, bismillah, $2,500? Do we have that? I need 3 or 4 of us, inshallah. $2,500. Jazakallah khair, ya akhi. May Allah accept it from you. Who'll be number two, inshallah? $2,500. If it's hard to make it one payment, make it 5 payments. Make it 10 payments, inshallah. Between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, you'll not regret it. One more person to say that, inshallah. Okay. Jazakallah khair, ya akhi. May Allah accept it from you. So far, we have 5,000. We can make this 5,000, 10,000. 5 of us, each one will say $1,000. Who are, inshallah, give me 5 hands, each one will save $1,000, one payment or 5, 10 payments, whatever you like, inshallah. Bismillah, let it go for Gaza, let it go for the udhiyah of your choice, inshallah. Who will be the first one to say $1,000, inshallah? Bismillah, give me some hands, inshallah. Inshallah, you'll not regret, you'll be proud of this, inshallah. Inshallah, you'll see the blessing of this in this life and in the life after. Inshallah, may Allah make it a protection for you, your business, your family, inshallah, your relationship. Who will be the first person, inshallah? $1,000. Can we have 5 hands? Bismillah, bismillah. $1,000, $1,000, 1 payment, 2 payments, 5 payments, inshallah. Okay, can I go down to $500? Show me a few hands, let me count a few hands. Bismillah, okay. I'm sure many of the brothers like to donate, do not like to raise their hands. I'll be next to the table. If you like to use your credit card, choose your udhiyah, inshallah. You can slide your card, get your receipt. Barakallah fikum.